We have launched the largest fleet of satellites in history to image the entire Earth's landmass once per day in order to understand how we're changing the planet and to take care of it. I'm Will Marshall, co-founder and CEO of Planet. We use space to help humanity in many ways, to help us to navigate, help us to communicate, help us to watch television, to watch and understand how the Earth works and understand climate change. People will make smarter decisions, whether that's locally or globally. It can help from the world leaders understanding how we are performing against our climate goals that are set out under the Paris Agreement or the Sustainable Development Goals, the global goals that were set out in the UN in 2015, how we are doing against those. So we can help doing what we call the measurement verification reporting of against our global goals by measuring how well we're doing against deforestation, measuring how we're doing against stopping illegal fishing, measuring how we're doing against feeding the world or providing water security to everyone in the world. We went and set about building a large fleet of satellites. It would take over 150 satellites to get to imaging the whole Earth once per day. And we set ourselves that goal. And first we had to miniaturize satellites that were the size of a bus and make them a few kilograms in mass and that you could hold in your hand. And then we could launch so many that we could take images of the whole planet. So basically our satellites are telescopes with cameras and radio systems and various other systems that enable them to control themselves. But they're big cameras looking down at the Earth taking pictures. And we have 150 of these and they take a snapshot of the entire landmass of the Earth each day. Now, why is that interesting? That's interesting because it helps us to improve agricultural productivity. So 25% of the land area of the Earth is agricultural land, so farmers, and we can help them to improve their crop efficiency by telling how well the crop is doing during the crop's growing seasons. Or forest management, so forests represent about 25% of the land area of the Earth as well. And we can actually tell if there's a tree that falls down. And then, if it's an illegal logging activity, then we could alert the local government to stop that illegal logging activity. So we can, with that method, help stop deforestation around the planet. Similarly, in the oceans, we can track and stop illegal fishing. We can also help with this sort of data on disaster response, so after floods or fires or earthquakes. Not only having the picture quickly after those events so that we can see what's happened, but also having the picture from the day before the event so we know exactly what changed before and afterwards. One of the most fascinating things that's happening in our field now is we're collecting all this imagery of the Earth, but now we have AI coming in that enables us to understand that data much more readily. In fact, the tantalizing proposition is that we can take any image and find objects in it with computer vision, with the latest machine learning. The same computer vision techniques that are used by Google to find cats and dogs in a picture can be used to find ships or planes or roads or buildings in our images. And if we can do that object identification in all of our images, then we can basically build up a database of where everything is on the planet every day. And therefore, we can then query that database. How many trees on the Amazon? Tell me which ones were knocked down between last week and this week. By imaging the whole Earth every day, it changes it from being just aware of it consciously to being able to take action to help take care of the planet. Because to take care of a planet, you have to measure it more quickly than you're changing it. Otherwise, you can't do anything about that. We are all sitting on a spaceship. It's called the spaceship Earth. And the Earth is hurtling around the sun and with 7 billion astronauts on board. And we all have to take care of our fragile ecosystems. And to do so, we need to measure them really quite rapidly so that, for example, we can stop that deforestation, stop destroying the habitats of other species, and to take good care of our beautiful spaceship.